Alrighty guys, here we are, game number two between Trident eSports and Tainted Minds. Tainted Minds are taking out the first game in pretty dominant fashion after a rough early game. Lynx, any final thoughts on that game before we head into picks and bans?
Yes, Trident need to do a much better job in this pick and ban phase just to ensure they don't get outdrafted like last game. They need to ban out heroes that have that strong teamfight ability, like the Kepri, like the Sol. Like, they need to get rid of everything that makes Tainted Minds such a strong, fierce competitor.
What do you think Trident need to pick up in this pick and ban phase to make themselves competitive in this one?
If Odin isn't in, then maybe Odin if he doesn't get banned, but otherwise I would say just pick someone who's survivable.
Alrighty, we can see Kepri gonna be the first ban away here as we head into picks and bans from Trident, and now Odin taken away by Tainted Minds.
Yes, the Odin straight away is a great pick by Tainted Minds. As I mentioned, that would be the one way to stop the team fight from happening. So he just completely shuts down anyway from trying to force a massive team fight.
Raijin now banned out by Trident Esports. So a lot of damage being taken off the board with that mid lane pick, although Slicey really likes himself a Sol as well.
Yes, if he's able to get that Sol, I feel like he can still do a lot of work. We've seen Slicey pick up Sol quite a bit this split. Even though he is famous for his Poseidon, his Sol play is also very good.
So kept taken away by Tainted Minds that are looking to take away from Ultimate Abyss's Godpool. Guan Yu now picked up by Trident Esports.
Yes, the Guan Yu is a lovely pickup there. It just allows you to have that extra bit of sustain in teamfight. Not to mention the fact that his Cavalry Charge plus Tower Assault is one of the best teamfight's abilities in the game.
Tyrant and Sol picked up here by Tainted Minds, some more comfort picks, I kind of want to say, but also at the same time, very strong picks for the side of Tainted Minds. Chiron, one of Gruff's favorite gods. Sol, one of Slicey's more well-known gods, as you mentioned previously, and they just provide so much damage for their team, and it's really good for taking down structures and objectives as well. Athena and Janus now picked up by Trident.
I really like this combination of both Janus and Athena. It really allows you to rotate thoroughly. Ultimate Abyss, we saw him last game play that Thor and doing quite a good amount of rotations. But with this Athena and Janus now, they can really just go wherever they want on the map. Speaking of Thor, picked up on the side of Tainted Minds to counter the amount of mobility that is on the side of Trident Esports.
This is the god that Shred played through 95% of the qualifiers for the OPL, so it's definitely a god that he's very comfortable with. Neath now banned away by Tainted Minds.
Neath is an interesting ban. They probably want to try and take away the aggression from Trident Esports duo lane. Athena has a very strong early duo lane presence with that Taunt, the shield wall, as well as the preemptive strike. So just removing that Neath allows the fact that they just can't get rooted in lane, and allow Chiron to have a little bit of an easier time in lane.
Geb now banned away by Trident, and Medusa banned away by Tainted. Again, this is something we saw during their banning phases against Pandemonium. They really don't want to have to go up against the Athena-Medusa combo.
Not to mention the fact that Chiron is such a strong ADC that if you can allow him to force someone against that strong Chiron with weak lane clear, they're just going to walk all over them. Speaking of people walking underneath things though, we have Sobek getting banned away on the side of Trident if they don't want Idivine picking it up again.
Bacchus immediately taken here by Tainted Minds. That's going to be going the way of Tomolomu. So a fair few knockups here on the side of Tainted Minds. Maybe we see in a Willix. We've seen Idivine play Assassins in the solo lane before. He's a very janky solo lane. I wouldn't surprise me to see him play it, although I would be highly doubtful of it. Bellona and Apollo now picked up for Trident Esports. So that's either a Bellona or a Guan Yu jungle link.
My guess is my money is on the Guan Yu jungle just because you have that extra little bit of rotation power from the Warrior's Rill and the Cavalry Charge. While Bellona has that extra little bit of sustain in lane, especially due to the fact she will be going up against an Osiris. Osiris, one of the bigger bully warriors, allowing, he just is clears way very easily, both with the Sickle Strike, the Spirit Flail, as well as the fact that his auto attack progression is one of the best in the game. But the Barkus as well as the Osiris combos give a lot of anti-healing to deal with both the Guan Yu as well as the Bellona healing. So I'm very interested to see how Trident deal with Tainted Minds at draft.
Alrighty boys, we're heading into game now. It is Trident Esports up against Tainted Minds. The series stands 1-0 in favor of Tainted Minds. Can they clean up the series and improve their chances of going to land, or can Trident complete a comeback? We'll just have to see. But let's go ahead and introduce our teams. On the left side of your spectator UI, under the blue health bars, we have got Trident Esports, El Kuro in the solo lane on Bellona, Ultimate Abyss in the jungle as Guan Yu, the Beast in the mid lane as Janus, Destiny and Just Laney make up your duo lane as Athena and Apollo.
And on the side of Tainted Minds, which is on your right side of your spectator UI, we have Eye Divine on the Osiris in the solo lane, Shred on that Thor in the jungle, Slicey on his Sol in the mid lane, and the duo lane will be comprised of Tomolomo on the Barkas and Gruff on Chiron.
Right, so we can see again Tainted Minds putting out their standard set of wards, Trident as well, warding up around the duo side of things.
Yes, and also we see Slicey picking up a strategy from the base last game, actually going into that pebble pot.
So he's going to be looking to get down some early damage. Dread as well has got the red pot. We see he and Eye Divine starting up the mid camps, while Trident just going to go ahead and take their blue.
We see, oh yeah, as you see, Bologna is just kind of sitting back at those back camps. There's not much you can really do against an Osiris. He's going to completely bully you in lane. He hasn't picked up a relic yet, but I would not be surprised if he went into a weakening curse possibly, or even a sprint, just to be able to really chase down those targets on the side of Trident.
Ultimibus in the base clearing up the mid lane here. Ultimibus getting to lane just a little bit before Shred. Shred looking to play a little bit aggressively here, as you'd expect a Thor red pot to do.
Yes, Thor can really, as we saw last game, he can apply a lot of pressure early, especially with that red pot. They easily are able to secure those mid camps. However, over in the duo lane,
Destinate taking a lot of damage here from Gruff and Tomolomo. He's running into the jungle here. He knows he's there, jumping up and down. First blood in under a minute, going the way of Tainted Minds.
Barkas, you don't really see as an early game hero, but paired with the power that is Chiron, Chiron can really make any support an early game support, as they are able to output a lot of damage early on.
Over on the solo lane, Eye Divine nearly soloed there by El Hero, but just manages to escape under his own tower.
Yes, Eye Divine does need to be careful early, as the bludgeon can really output a lot of damage, as it just powers up the more heroes you hit, the minions you can hit, as well as the fact the bludgeon gives you a nice bit of a cleave to compete with the Osiris, who is a naturally good auto-attack progression.
Akira now clearing the wave as well, perhaps looking for some more aggression onto Eye Divine. We can see that the Beast and Ultimate Abyss are hanging around the fire minions, but Ultimate Abyss are not going to swing around to the solo lane to help out his solo laner.
Yes, and in the mid lane, we see the Beast and Ultimate Abyss were able to pick up the Fire Elementals as they rotate back to lane, while Slicey and Shred did the back camps on the solo side. The Stellar Burst can do quite a lot of damage, plus the Thorwall, as well as that nice Facia coming out from Yanis to stop Shred from doing any damage.
And Ultimate Abyss has got a heal as well, so he's not too worried about taking poke, because as a Guan Yu, he could just heal it all back up.
Also, I'm excited to see if he goes into that Bluestone or not, because Bluestone on Guan Yu early really does pack a punch combined with that Tower of Soul channeling. And due to the fact they have the Athena on their side, they can ensure that he can't be stopped from channeling. The only real way to stop him would actually be to stun him with the Barkas Belch.
Oh, Portal there nearly catches out Shred, but he teleports away with his Mjolnir's Attunement. Dread now clearing out the minions in the mid wave along with Slicey. They both hit level 5, whereas the Beast and Ultimate Abyss are still just below on level 4.
And over in the duo lane, we see Gruff is now also hit by, while Tomolomo going in for a nice belly flop there.
Messed out by Laney, Destinate pushes away there, going to be able to prevent any more damage coming out. Shred looking to perhaps go up in the air here and aggress into the mid lane. He's just hanging around the wall here, waiting for the perfect opportunity. Up he goes, Slicey coming through very aggressively. They're looking for Ultimate Abyss maybe. Where's Shred going to land? He misses both members. He was a bit too indecisive there, but gets a nice wall off. Ultimate Abyss takes a lot of damage. Tomolomu's here as well. Can they find the jungler? Tomolomo with the belly flop finds the jungler from Trident.
Yes, and to finish it off, he threw down his wine jug and just completely made sure that Ultimate Abyss was not coming back. Great start from the side of Tainted Minds, as they really want to get this early advantage, not even give them a chance to come back, as they now are taking away the blue buff from the side of Trident.
Yeah, nothing El Hero can really do about that. Four members of Tainted Minds there. No one really to support El Hero, as Ultimate Abyss is in base and the Beast has got no mana.
Nice blink coming out from Yanis there, as he was able to dodge that Thorwall using the portal to escape. However, that means Tainted Minds are able to secure the mid camps on the right hand side. We see that Bologna forced to actually go to the back camps to get that extra bit of experience she's missing from that blue buff that was stolen away by Tainted Minds.
Right now, looking towards mid lane, the Beast still yet to back 1200 gold in his pocket, just waiting to save up for that Doom Orb, I feel.
I don't know if it would be a good idea to pick up a Doom Orb for Yanis. Yanis, even though he does have the 3 space and time as well as the 4 to get away, if he does get crippled or caught out, all those Doom Orb stacks will be for nothing, and he will just be a very sad person. I can understand picking up a Doom Orb on Sol just because of the fact she can actually make herself completely damage immune, which is a huge benefit out of any mage in the mid lane. While Yanis, he needs to be careful if he does build it to ensure he doesn't get caught in the backline thanks to Shred being able to land on him with the Anvil of Dawn.
Right, looking towards solo side of things now, Divine's forced Alkiro out of lane a couple of times now. Alkiro teleporting back in to try and regain some of that lost XP and gold. But iDivine really getting the better of this lane.
Yes, iDivine just using the power of the Sickle Strike, the Flail, as well as his auto attacks to just clear the wave as fast as possible and apply that pressure to Bellona that she really can't come back with an answer to. As we mentioned earlier, Yanis has indeed gone into the Doom Orb, as well as Apollo is now starting to stack the Devourer's Gauntlets.
He takes a poke in the mid lane, but goes incorporeal, so really not worrying about it that much at all. iDivine again poking out Alkiro in the solo lane.
Yes, iDivine being extremely aggressive. He's still, we actually haven't seen any of the ultimate coming out from iDivine, but that does apply a root as well as 100% anti-healing. Kind of similar to Odin, except it's not in a giant AoE.
Gold Fury watered up now by Trident, but there is some vision in that area by Tainted Minds. Shred's up in the air now. He's looking for Laney, and Destinate slams down there. Laney taking a lot of damage. Gruff with the ultimate shell pop by Destinate. Laney going up into the sky, but Shred catches him just before he can escape.
However, Trident aren't going to be happy with that as they try and use the 3 space and time to rotate. It is not in time, as every single member from Tainted Minds are able to get away with that 3 kill. Having a look at our grass, we see it is a 2,100 XP lead for Tainted Minds and a 1,500 gold lead. Ultimate Abyss trying to aggress on Slicey.
Looking for him there, but not going to find it. Shred and Tomolomu in the area able to save their mid laner.
Yes, and now Shred is just going to go back into the jungle. He's been doing a very good job this game, one level ahead of Guan Yu, and he has just been doing a great job landing the Anvil of Dawn in the door lane, picking up a very nice kill that normally would have fallen if only Gruff and Tomolomu were there.
You can see now Ultimate Abyss fighting a little bit here with iDivine, but not really looking for much at the moment. Tomolomu is here along with Shred. Shred, let's check when his ultimate's going to be up. Another 20 seconds, so expect another engagement after that. Puts down the wall there to prevent the beast coming through and possibly looking to steal away the blue buff.
Interestingly enough, both supports have started both either building into the wing blade on the side of the Athena for Destinate, while Barkus, played by Tomolomu, has actually finished his winged blade and only opted for the tier 1 boots. Normally, this is actually fine due to the fact that you'd still get the full movement speed as you would just building normal boots. However, a nice roll coming out from Destinate trying to see if they can find anything on Tomolomu.
Oh, 3-man belly flop into an Anvil of Dawn. 3 members have tried it extremely low as the beast just barely manages to get out alive. Destinate absolutely destroyed there. Great CC combination and damage combination there from Tainted Minds.
Shred doing a great job teleporting into the last second, getting that one last auto attack needed. Gruff picking up a kill on just landing in the Doi lane. Really showing the difference between power between the Devourer's Gauntlets and that Transcendence. Transcendence, even though it does not give you lifesteal, gives you that extra bit of mana as well as physical power. Not to mention the fact it will actually stack 25 stacks quicker than the Devourer's Gauntlets.
Oh, iDivine there uses the ultimate but doesn't manage to hit Alkiro. Alkiro with the Eagles Rally looking for iDivine and picks him up. Solo kill there for Trident.
Finally, Trident are able to find their first kill. Great Eagles Rally there by Bellona, giving her that extra bit of protection. She is actually very close to finishing the Breastplate of Valor. However, in the mid lane, we see the T1 tower has fallen to the side of Trident to Tainted Minds, and Trident are now just going to have to regroup and see what they can do for the next Gold Fury fight.
Let's take a look at our graphs here. 4,600 the XP, 3,200 the gold difference, all in favor of Tainted Minds. Trident again finding themselves on the back foot.
Looking at the player damage though, we see that iDivine topping the charts at 4,900, closely followed by Gruff. Both of them been doing a great job in lane, completely harassing out their fellow lane partners. And even though iDivine fell earlier, he is actually still doing fairly well and is actually just, even though he's a tiny bit behind thanks to that death from before, I'm sure he'll be absolutely fine and we'll actually be able to use that teleport to go into those Gold Fury fights later on.
Laney is 3 levels behind Gruff at this point, not a good look. Destinate falls down to Gruff there, puts Gruff even further ahead of just Laney.
Yes, Destinate has not had a last 2 good games. He's been dying constantly, now onto his 3rd death of the game, picking up half the kills that Tainted Minds have been able to pick up. Hasn't actually been able to finish up the Winged Blade. As I said last game, I'll say it again, I would much rather see the Athena start building into that Heart of the Urchin early instead of this Winged Blade that doesn't give you any protections.
Already looking towards the solo side of things again. Idivine, despite getting solo just before, pushing El Kiro under his tower and applying damage to the solo tower.
Yes, there's not much threat that El Kiro can do due to the fact that Idivine has the every time he uses an ability at up to 8 points, he will be getting extra damage mitigation. Not to mention the fact his Judgment Tether also gives him mitigation. He is just a very, very tanky warrior, and there's not very much El Kiro can do except try and land the bludgeon.
See now three members of Trident around the Gold Fury pit, along with two members of Tainted Minds and Slicey rotating in now as well. Trident perhaps looking to contest here and prevent Tainted Minds from getting it for free. Shred gets some poke there down onto Ultimate Abyss.
Yes, Shred able to land the double tap. He's been very accurate with the double tap so far this game, really using the wall. However, over in the solo, then we see Idivine going in on El Kiro.
Ultimate Abyss there was also forced to use the cavalry charge, but he mentioned El Kiro poked out a lot there by Idivine. Trident across the board just being absolutely bullied.
And now the third blue buff will be going to the way of Tainted Minds as the Gold Fury is now being started up. No ward coverage by Trident, and that will be a free Gold Fury in the way of Tainted Minds. Let us have a look at the graphs as this Gold Fury is about to fall. And now the XP difference is 7,000 experience, 5,000 gold. This is already starting to look very much out of hand for the way of Trident. They are getting outclassed and outmatched completely by Tainted Minds.
Laney forced to dash away there from a rotation out of Tomolomu and Shred towards his lane. Buff still sitting three levels above him. I don't think Laney's going to be able to defend this tier 1 tower. Idivine and Slicey also rotating to this side of the map.
Yes, and Gruff already starting to build into that RC. Just Laney being Defender of Olympus landing on top of him to get that extra bit of damage mitigation. However, Shred able to get the kill on the back line.
Shred absolutely shredding down Just Laney there. He's up in the air now. Maybe looking for Ultimate Abyss, who's under his own tower, but he misses him again. Lands instead onto Destinate, who's taken very low. Again, Gruff's got himself a double kill. El Kiro looking for Gruff, picks him up with the hammer, and now Shred taken low as well. Eagles Rally lands onto two Tainted Minds, but Tomolomu with an excellent belly flop saves his jungler. The Beast looking to apply some damage, but it's not going to be enough. And now Tainted Minds forced away from the tower. Good defense from Trident, but Tainted Minds still pick up the kills that they were looking for.
Yes, Grub has just been exponentially getting stronger and stronger. We're really seeing the power of Chiron. The Beast there, we saw a little bit of him coming through as he was able to land that unstable vortex. He still has the 50 Doom Orb stacks. Out of everyone on the team, him as well as El Kiro are the only ones who haven't died yet. So if he's able to stay alive and make it through this mid game, he might actually be able to win these team fights.
When you've got a duo lane that's currently sitting at 0-7 though, it's going to be very difficult.
Yes, Laney going to the Devour's Gauntlets, not proving to be that good as Gruff is just using the power of the Arcee and the Transcendence to just completely outbox the Apollo. Usually you see Apollo being the one who's one of the best boxers in the game, but if he's three levels behind Chiron, with the fact that Chiron can use the Masterful Shot as well as heals every time he uses an ability almost constantly, there is not much Just Laney can do except for the fact that he needs to just try and split push and not get caught out.
Oh, Gruff now looking for Laney. Masterful Shot is available to slow him down if he wants. He's not going to try and waste that ability just yet. Laney is just trying to desperately hold out this tower. Shred, he's up in the air, lands down onto the Beast of Destinate after they portal through. The Beast purifies away. Tomolomu looking for the mid laner, but Destinate is the one that's caught out. Dashes away now from the aggression of Tainted Minds. Ultimate Abyss is here, but what can he do? The answer is almost nothing, as now Tainted Minds are looking for the tier 1 on the left. Tomolomu and Idivine standing behind Just Laney. He's got no way out. He's sitting there, dashes away. He is not accepting his death, actually, looking to get away, but Idivine picks up the kill, and now Ultimate Abyss on the horse, dashing away. Left-hand side, tier 1 falls, and if Tainted Minds want, the tier 2 will fall down as well.
However, just as a little minor victory for Trident, Bologna was actually able to split push and secure the tier 1 tower in the solo lane. However, as you said, it seems like very much that Tainted Minds will be getting this tier 2 tower in the duo lane.
Yeah, tier 2 tower does fall down. El Kiro, as you mentioned, picks up the tier 1 on the right-hand side. Tainted Minds gonna back, taking a look at our graphs. 9,000 XP, 6,800 the gold difference between these two teams.
And if we have a look at our player damage, we see Shred topping the charts, doing a great job, doing 8,700 damage, followed close by Gruff. Gruff been constantly doing a great job this game, landing those masterful shots and all the auto attacks he needs. Chiron, he is just such a strong ADC in this meta. I don't know what Trident can do. They seem to be getting outdrafted for the second time this series.
Tomolomu jumps away there from the aggression of Trident. Laney dashing after Gruff here, doing a lot of damage. There is the Athena ultimate. Gruff looking to fight here. Destinate dashing forward. No, he leaves Gruff alone, actually.
Gruff able to use that giddy up, and the Beast using the 3 space in time to go back into the mid lane.
Slicey taking a lot of damage here. Detonate taunts in Slicey, but Slicey able to get away. And now Trident, they're feeling some of the damage from Tainted Minds. They poured absolutely everything into that fight. Dread goes up into the air. He's looking to land down. Great Anvil of Dawn right onto Elkyro. Shell popped by Detonate, but it's not going to mitigate enough damage as Elkyro takes a hell of a lot of hurt there from Shred, who falls down just barely to Ultimate Abyss, who heals up his team.
Ultimate Abyss proving that the conviction is stronger on the side of Trident there, able to barely keep, as he said, kill that Bologna alive as she was forced to back, teleport nearly coming in there, while they're now looking to push down that T1 tower in the mid lane.
Detonate dashes in but pays for it with his life as Slicey and Gruff absolutely destroy him.
Yes, I don't understand why Destinate is going in as Gruff is 6 levels above Destinate. This is not the time for you to be engaging in teamfights like that. You need to look to be more of a ganking orientated lineup, especially with the mobility you have. It isn't that hard to do. They just can't take these 5v5 engagements because they're always going to end up on the raw end of the deal. Gold Fury coming very close to respawning in only another 10 seconds, and most likely that will go the way of Tainted Minds.
There's not really much that Trident can hope to stop him with other than maybe a Janna snipe stealing it away at the last second.
And a surrender vote coming out from Trident. They are not very happy right now as they have fallen quite far behind. They are behind by it would be 8 kills now, sorry, can't do maths. And they are just trying to find somebody to get back. If they can get this goal through, as you said, possibly with a Janna snipe, possibly with a Polo, possibly with Bologna and the Eagles rally, they might be in this. But right now, this is very much looking, again, like Tainted Minds' game.
Ultimate Abyss taking a lot of poke there from Tomolomu, Gruff, and Shred. And he might fall down here in just a second. Tomolomu secures the kill with the backer's ultimate. Oh, Laney, where are you going, son? It doesn't look like very far. Going up into the ultimate, just barely managed to make it alive. Gruff does have a masterful shot. Did he use it in time to take out Laney? No, he didn't. But that is a lot of Trident forced out. And now Gold Fury started up by Tainted Minds.
Even though they weren't able to pick up the kill there on just Laney, they forced him back, as he said, using that across the skies, and now that is free round and Gold Fury. The Beast does have the Janna's ultimate up, and we'll see if he can try and take it. However, Tainted Minds able to completely melt that Gold Fury with the help of 4 members of the team. The Beast trying to snipe it, but way too late.
The Beast almost picks up Slicey there, but unable to get it. Tomolomu picks out Detonate, who's just dashing in and dying in all of these fights. The Beast, get out, son, but Slicey is chasing him down. Gruff picks up just Laney. Beast manages to get out, but Tainted Minds just having their way with Trident.
Elkyro forced to pop the sprint and is now back with only Ultimate Abyss left to defend the tower at level 11. This seems like it's going to be another tier 2 tower to fall on the side of Tainted Minds, with only one tower falling on their side. And this is actually the second last tier 2 with Shred picking up a great kill on Ultimate Abyss.
Solo lane, the only lane left for Trident that has any towers available. Tainted Minds looking in that direction, just looking to get some free golden XP.
Yes, Thor really doing work with that Brawler's bait stick there, ensuring that Guan Yu just can't output the heal damage he normally does. And since he's so far behind, usually you max the heal last. The heal right now is not going to be doing much at all for the side of Trident as they try and regroup and figure out how the hell are they going to win this game.
And one tower falls to one in-hand attack from Shred. Elkyro looking to chase down Tainted Minds and put some damage on the board for himself, but there's just not much one man can do at this point. Athena ultimate incoming as the Eagles rally comes out as well. No damage applied there though, as a great wall from Shred prevents it. 3-man taunt from Destinate, but there's no follow-up as the rest of his team is just not in position. Gruff coming in with the Centaurus ultimate, looking for Destinate, who's one hit away. Gruff gets himself a kill now as Elkyro diving into the backline. Gruff now doing a lot of damage to Elkyro. Giddy up, chasing him down. Elkyro taken very low, but manages to get away. Beast with the ultimate. Shred with a better one comes crashing down. Slicey picked up by the Beast.
And now while that's going on, iDevice using that Judgment Tower to get that extra bit of damage mitigation. Ultimate Abyss able to pick up the kill with the Cavalry Charge as well as the Tower Assault. But Gruff finishes off just landing in the backline while Shred is stunned out by the final bit of the Cavalry Charge. Bludgeon not able to hit its mark.
Elkyro very low here, uses the Scourge to stop any more basic attacks coming up from Gruff. Spin to win from Shred. Elkyro with the hammer picks up Tomolomu on the backside. Elkyro, like a fantastic game, better than we've ever seen so far. Unfortunately for him, his team is not giving him anything to work with.
Gruff using the Giddy up there to try and chase down Elkyro. Elkyro is juking as best he can in that Fire Giant pit, but that will be to no avail as Gruff picks up the final kill of that very long extended team fight. Ultimate Abyss trying to find someone with Destinate, taunting out Gruff with Ultimate Abyss in the backline.
Gruff has got his RC proc now as well, so he's not going down anytime soon. Destinate and Ultimate Abyss forced to back off their Gruffs now. Let's take a look. 15,000 XP, 10,000 gold, the difference between these two squads.
That is very much looking like F6 territory for Trident Esports, as they just haven't been, even in that team fight, there was just not enough coordination to finally pick up the team. The Beast doing a great job going into the backline, using that 50 Dream Orb at that point to finish off the kill with the Unstable Vortex. However, that was not enough. Judgment Tether allowing that extra tiny bit of damage mitigation to really ensure he survived that long drawn out team fight. I don't know if Trident, they actually seem to be pulling together quite nicely now. They're doing a little bit better in the team fights than they were doing before, but now we can see that Gruff has already hit 19 compared to Just Lani, who's only 14. This is very much looking like Tainted Minds' game.
Just Lani, they're forced to purification away there. Up the air he goes, just looking to escape some more damage, doesn't want to put any more deaths on the board.
Yeah, usually you see Apollo use Across the Skies as a way to split push. Just they haven't given Apollo a single inch to split push. Wherever he goes, you'll find that Tainted Minds have been following as well.
Tainted Minds now pushing down the right-hand side here, looking for the Tier 2 tower, the last remaining tower for Trident Esports.
And now the Beast putting up a portal there, backing preemptively, ensuring Shred can't stun him out, while a lovely taunt coming out from Ultimate Abyss as well as Destinate allowed things to go on.
Lady bought a teleport, teleports into the tower and immediately dies. Brendavoke started up now for Trident, and they're looking just to get out of this one and move on to the next series, which will be against Direwolves. But it is it doesn't look like that Brendavoke is being accepted by the rest of the team. Tainted Minds now, all towers down, looking now towards the Fire Giant.
Yes, Tainted Minds, even though they did lose the last set to Pandemonium, this set they've shown why they are the number two team in OCE right now. Just applying so much pressure, so much great teamfight coordination. Just, they were able to completely outclass Trident. I don't know. Trident most likely they'll definitely be going to relegation since they still are sitting around the bottom of the ladder. While Tainted Minds will be going to land, in my opinion.
A team fight here, Gruff taken pretty low. El Cairo uses his ultimate. Gruff falls down there to El Kiro. There is a weakening curse now. Destinate out of the fight. Can ultimate back in if he needs to, but I fear it'll be over before then. Sanctuary used by the Beast to try and get out. Good wall there from Shred. Still not picking up the kill. He's just chasing him down and picks him up with an in-hand. El Cairo fighting 1v3. Can't do anything at this point. Looking to bludgeon, but Tomolomu picks up the kill. Laney falls down there to Shred. And now Shred going up the air to escape the death, but Ultimate Abyss picks him up with the Talalau Assault.
And now he's using the Tower of Assault, he's just hiding around that red buff, trying to make sure he doesn't get poked out by Eye Divine as well as Tomolomu. He's now actually running in towards the direction of Tainted Mind's base, just trying to distract them that extra bit longer, give Destinate just that little bit more time for farm. She does have the Heart of the Urchin with one stack on it, but if we compare that to Tomolomu, who's level 15, three levels ahead as well as 10 stacks, I don't know what Athena can really do in this team fight other than just die.
Gold Fury now started up by Tainted Minds just to prevent Trident Esports to get back into this one at all, but I don't think they even need to really worry about that. 16,000 XP, 12,000 the gold before the Gold Fury. Let's take a look at what happens afterwards. 18,000 XP, 13,000 gold. Trident, I don't know, man. I just don't think that they can make it back into this one.
I feel like the most telling thing of why Trident are losing, have a look at Laney. He still has not finished stacking his Devourer's Gauntlet. It is 20 minutes into the game, hasn't been able to find 75 minion kills. That is how much aggression that has just been coming out from Tainted Minds. Laney, just Destinate not being able to support him as well. He's just been forced to die constantly and use that Across the Skies as the most defensive kind of escape, not even getting a single chance to split push.
Righty, let's take a look now at what Tainted Minds are looking to do. 22 minutes, 45 seconds reads the game clock as we seem to be coming towards the closing stages of this game. All towers down for Trident Esports, all remaining but one for Tainted Minds. Destinate now looking for something towards the towards Slicey. Shred has gone up. Laney comes crashing down onto Slicey. Shred comes crashing down right afterwards and looking for Laney, but two portals there. Laney to make his pick of how to escape. Ultimate Abyss goes through. Doesn't find anything worth fighting for.
And Gruff now trying to trade out Ultimate Abyss, getting off that Talosol plus the Intoxicate coming out from Barkus.
Ultimate Abyss takes a lot of damage there. The Beast using the Unstable Vortex. Good Eagles rally from El Kiro, but doesn't manage to find anything as Gruff stuff Destinate. Just Laney falls to Eye Divine. Shred very low in the back as El Kiro is doing so much damage at this point. Ultimate Abyss forced the cavalry charge out. The Beast looking to apply some damage, but got no one to apply it on. El Kiro doing damage in the back line, but forced to back away. And Tainted Minds, a little bit indecisive here. Maybe thinking about going for this mid-Phoenix.
I like them going for the Phoenix. They have the Soul, they have the Chiron, same as last game. They will have no issue at all pushing down this mid-Phoenix, or even possibly the Duo as well as the solo Fennec. So
Beast getting stunned out there by the belt. Through the portal, but no damage following up from that stun. Tainted Minds take the mid Phoenix, and it looks like maybe they want to end going for the right hand side Phoenix, playing a little bit safer.
However, nice one coming out from Destinate as well as the through space and time.
Destinate picks up a kill there. The Beast should pick up Slicey here. Good return there from Trident Esports, not going down without a fight. Tomolomu jumps up into the air. Idivine taking a lot of damage here, but he's just so tanky at the moment. He's not worrying about it. Bulwark of Hope proc here, but he shouldn't survive this one much longer. The Beast picks up another kill.
That was an incredible job by the Beast as well as Destinate. Even though Destinate may be behind in levels, she still has enough levels on that taunt to ensure that no one is getting away from that through space in time.
Trident's doing the fire giant.
They're doing the fire. Tomolomu and Shred are still there, and there are ultimates up for Tomolomu as well as Shred. Shred going into the air.
This is Trident needs to do this at this point though to even have a hope of being in the game. Tomolomu picks up one kill and it's all falling apart for Trident now. Shred taken very low. Fire Giant still doing damage. El Kiro picks up Shred. Stop chasing Tomolomu, guys. Just do the Fire Giant. Tomolomu now taken pretty low, but that was the only hope Trident had of getting back into this one.
And now 5 minutes are pouring into the pit of Trident Esports Titan as Slicey as well as Gruff are now alive and kicking again. The Beast able to pick up a kill on Tomolomu, but what have they sacrificed trying to kill Tomolomu?
They still could have picked up the Fire Giant there, I think, if they just had one person zone out Tomolomu. It's really unfortunate for Trident. Now they're forced to back and defend. Fire Giant still up for Tainted Minds to take at their own discretion, but they may not even need it. They may just choose to come in and end this game.
With 5 minutes pouring down the mid lane as well as the solo lane, the duo lane is going to take a while for it to get there, but in the mid and solo lane, you can very much see the minions are very close to the Titan, and if they just group up 10 mines, if they want, just could take that Titan and end it. The level difference is still massive. 5 between the ADCs, 2 between the supports. There is no level difference, surprisingly, between the mids. The Beast has been doing a great job to stay alive in this game. And surprisingly, El Kiro is already level 20 ahead of iDivine, who's only 19. But those are the very few saving graces of the game. It's through space and time used to try and get back to the Fire Giant.
Yeah, trying to their thought. Tainted Minds were already starting that one up and trying to steal it away there. Laney used his ultimate as well, so 2 wasted ultimates for Trident there. I think, though, Laney has just given up in this game and was just using the ultimate to scout out rather than for any dank strat.
Yes, and now Sol with the Soul Reaver. Yeah, that's a good one. She's now actually able to apply even more damage with the Stellar Burst or the Supernova. There is no Yanis here that actually might be able to build up that Rod of Tahuti. It may be so too late, as even though he's been able to get off the damage with the through space and time with the Unstable Vortex, it just hasn't been enough, even though they nearly got the Fire Giant off it.
Ultimate is taking a lot of damage here. Gruff ends one of the snipes, but doesn't hit the other two. Ultimate Abyss forced to back away. He heals himself up a little bit, but he's still only 50% HP. The Beast now, let's take a look at him. 15 seconds till his ultimate's up, but the Fire Giant has been started here by Tainted Minds. Can Trident do anything to stop them? The answer, I fear, will be no.
And as that's going in the laning, in a one final last-ditch attempt, is trying to push down that Tier 1 tower in the duo lane. But while that's going on, that's going to be a free Fire Giant in the way of Tainted Minds. They're able to pick it up. Shred going into the air.
Destinate very low here, forced to dash away. The Beast Sanctuary, but nowhere for him to run. Ruff picks up a kill here, and now Divine looking for the rest of Trident Esports. This, I feel, is the Fat Lady singing, and no one and nothing is going to be able to save Trident at this point.
Just Laney able to get the Tier 2 tower over in the duel lane, but as that's going on, Tainted Minds are just pouring into the Titan as they want to end this before Just Laney can even attempt to take this Phoenix in the duel lane.
It looks like the Titan will fall here in just a second. 3/4 health is the Titan of Trident Esports. Ultimate is taken very low here, forced to dash away. Might just survive, but Destinate will not. Laney takes the left-hand side. Phoenix, he's looking to split push to win here. I don't think he's going to have the damage to pull it off, however, but it's going to make for an exciting finish nonetheless as Trident Esports just desperately trying to keep Tainted Minds out of the base, while Laney looks the end on the other side. The both Titans now taking some damage here, but Tainted Minds are going to be too quick on this damage. El Kiro picks up Tomolomu, but the Titan falls down before Laney can do anything about it. Tainted Minds pick up a victory.
Congratulations to Tainted Minds, doing a great job there, finishing up the series 2-0. Laney, you tried your hideout, you were so close, but you just couldn't get that Titan. It was 4v1 trying to take down a Titan, and the 4 heads are better than 1.
Alrighty, so Tainted Minds closes out that series 2-0, giving them an overall record of 3-2 for the week. Not bad, considering the quality of opposition they were up against in their first matchup against Pandemonium. MVP for the series is going to be Shred. Shred joining us now live. Shred, how are you feeling after that series?
You know, feeling pretty good, especially after the loss to Panda. Just needed something to, you know, lift the spirits.
Yeah. Alrighty, so picks and ban phase, you guys seem to have a plan. Both of your sets, you know, how much research do you guys put in during the week against your opposition?
We put definitely a lot more into Panda than we did into Trident. But, yeah, it was a rough week, but, you know, yeah.
Alrighty, Lynx, any questions for Shred?
So, just, like, I want to hear your mindset. What was going through your head at the time that Lanny was trying to take on the Titan? Did you guys think it was not an issue at all and you guys knew you could take it? Or was that, like, that slight bit of doubt going into trying to take the Titan?
I mean, Lanny had no kills, no farm. I mean, he was never going to end the game. It's a last, it's a nice last ditch effort, but yeah, it's pretty comfortable.
All right, before you leave us, Shred, any shout outs you want to give?
Just shout out to Tainted, best org in the league, and shout out to Big, be my husband.
Alrighty, thanks for joining us, Shred. That's going to do us for our second series of the day. Next up, we are going to have Sin Gaming up against Avant Garde. Bit of a rivalry match there. Some former teammates go at it. Very interested to see how that one will go. That's going to do me for tonight, though. Next up, we are going to have Alpha Jackal joining Lynx Clone on the commentary desk. But for now, we're going to take a short break, and we'll see you very shortly.